will discuss about map and the exercises of the chapter Major Rivers of India. So what is a map? A map is a symbolic representation of selected characteristics of a place, usually drawn on a flat surface. Maps present information about the world in a simple and visual way. They teach about the world by showing sizes and shapes of countries, locations and features, and distances between the places. Major rivers of India. So we are going to learn river map as well as the exercises. Now Himalayan perennial rivers and peninsular plateau, they are called the non-perennial rivers. So the perennial rivers are Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, Brahmaputra. Perennial rivers means the river those who are permanent in nature. Non-perennial rivers which are seasonal in nature. The first river you can see in the map is River Ganga. Now the origin of Ganga River is Western Himalayas in the state of Uttarakhand and flows south and east through the Gangetic plains of North India into Bangladesh, where it empties into Bay of Bengal. Now, as you already know, in Bangladesh, River Ganga is known as River Padma. Next river, River Indus. Now, Indus River, the origin is western part of Tibet. The river runs a course through northern India, Ladakh, into northern Pakistan, and then flows along the entire length of Pakistani Punjab to merge into the Arabian Sea. Yamuna River. Now, Yamuna River is a tributary of River Ganga, and the origin of Yamuna River is Yamunotri Glacier. On the southwestern slopes of Bandarpuch Peaks in the uppermost region of the lower Himalayas in Uttarakhand. Now, it is the longest river in India which does not directly flow into the sea. As you can see in the image at the point Allahabad, Sangam, where Ganga, Yamuna and the mythical river Saraswati meet. So Yamuna, it is the longest river in India which does not directly flow into the sea. Brahmaputra River. Now you can see in the image, like Brahmaputra River originates from the northern side of the Himalayas and flows across southern Tibet and enters into India through Arunachal Pradesh. You can see the green part. It flows southwest through the Assam Valley and enters Bangladesh. Now, Brahmaputra River is known as River Jamuna in Bangladesh before emptying into Bay of Bengal. Kaveri River, you can see in the image, River Kaveri. Now, Kaveri River covers the state Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, and one union territory, that is Puducherry. River Narmada. Now, as you already know, it is also known as lifeline of Madhya Pradesh for its huge contribution to the state of Madhya Pradesh. You can see there are dams made on the Narmada River, and it provides basic needs like agriculture, household purpose water, Next river, Mahanadi. Now Mahanadi is a major river in East Central India, as you already know. And the river flows through the state of Chhattisgarh and Odisha, earlier known as Orissa. Mahanadi River was known as Soro River in Orissa earlier, but now as dams are made, it is no longer considered a Soro River. And it is best, Mahanadi Valley is the best known for its fertile soil and flourishing agriculture. Next river is Krishna River. Now the Krishna River is also called Krishna Veni, and it is the major source of irrigation for Maharashtra, Karnataka, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. Now you can see in the map, Brahmaputra, Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, these are perennial rivers, and Mahanadi, Narmada, Krishna and Kaveri, these are non-perennial river. Now in the same manner, you can see the image, you will paste a river map of India in your social studies copies and mention these 8 rivers in the river map. Now we'll discuss the exercises of the chapter Major Rivers of India. Exercise A, answer the following questions. Question number 1, explain the term river. Now river is a large stream of water that flows in a channel towards an ocean, sea, a lake, or another river. Question number 2. Why are rivers considered most important resources in the world? Rivers are considered most important resources in the world as great civilization developed along the bank of rivers, and rivers provide water for industries, agriculture, commercial and domestic purposes. Now the third question, what are perennial and non-perennial rivers? So we'll make a table in our notebook and we'll write the difference in that table. Perennial rivers. Now perennial rivers are those rivers which exhibit a continuous flow of water throughout the year except extreme drought conditions. And non-perennial rivers are those rivers which have no flow for at least a part of the year. Nature. Perennial rivers are of permanent nature and non-perennial rivers are seasonal in nature. Maps. In map, generally, perennial rivers are shown with blue color and non-perennial rivers are shown with black color. Example of perennial river, Ganga and Indus. An example of non-perennial rivers, Kaveri and Krishna. Question number 4. Explain the Ganges River. Now the Ganges, also known as Ganga, is a transboundary river of Asia that begins in the western Himalayas, flows through India and Bangladesh and empties out into Bay of Bengal. Question number 5. Name and explain the lifeline of Madhya Pradesh. Answer. Narmada River is called the lifeline of Madhya Pradesh for its huge contribution to the state by providing water for irrigation, aquaculture, domestic purpose, etc. Next exercise, exercise B, fill in the blanks. First one, dash is a natural stream of water. River is a natural stream of water. Second, dash rivers are those rivers which exhibit a continuous flow throughout the year. Answer, perennial rivers are those rivers which exhibit a continuous flow throughout the year. Third, perennial rivers are shown with dash color on the map. Perennial rivers are shown with blue color on the map. Fourth, dash rivers have no flow for at least a part of the year. Non-perennial rivers have no flow for at least a part of the year. Fifth one, dash is the major river in East Central India. Answer, Mahanadi is the major river in East Central India. Sixth one, the Narmada River is also called the dash. The Narmada River is also called the Rewa. Seventh, dash is the most sacred river to Hindus. Ganga is the most sacred river to Hindus. Next exercise, C. Rearrange the jumbled words. Now, E, I, R, A, V, K. So, when we rearrange, it becomes river Kaveri. Second, D, A, N, I, H, A, A, M. And the answer, Mahanadi. Third, G, S, A, E, N, G. And the answer, Ganges. Fourth, S, U, N, I, D. Answer, Indus. Fifth one, A, Y, U, M, A, N. Answer, Yamuna. Last exercise, name the following. A large natural stream of water. Answer, river. Second, rivers of permanent nature. Answer, perennial river. Third, shown with black color on the map. Answer, non-perennial river. Fourth one, the river also known as Krishna Veni. The answer, river Krishna. Fifth, the river has supported irrigated agriculture for centuries. Answer, Kaveri. Sixth, the longest river in India which does not flow to sea. Answer, Yamuna, as it is a tributary of river Ganges. Seventh, the river also known as Sangpo Brahmaputra. Answer, Brahmaputra. Make sure to see the video carefully and I'll upload the word document of the exercise so that you can complete your work neatly in your FAIR notebook.